Hi, my name is Eric Hansen. I'm the Vice President of Technology here at Aculon, and today I'm going to teach you how to successfully apply the Aculon NanoClear fluxophobic stencil treatment.
The following instructional video is going to cover the proper application of Aculon NanoClear to your stencil. First, we need to start with the stencil you would like to treat. Your stencil is ready for priming if it is visually clean, has just been run through your stencil washer, or is freshly out of your electroplating bath. To determine if the stencil needs to be primed prior to application of the treatment, hold the stencil under running distilled water, then remove from the stream of water and hold it vertically for 30 seconds. If the stencil does not support an unbroken sheet of water, as seen here, then the stencil is not water break free and priming is required. If the surface is water break free, as seen here, then you can skip priming and move to the treatment step. Open and take the Part A primer wipe and wipe the stencil for at least 60 seconds. Do not open the Part B at this stage. Be sure to apply heavy pressure while wiping the Part A, as though you were buffing wax on a car. Remember, proper application of the primer is critical for final desired performance. After using Aculon Part A, rinse the stencil under running distilled or deionized water for at least 60 seconds. Tap water is not ideal, but can be used if DI water is not available. Remember, it is critical that the Part A primer is thoroughly rinsed from the surface with water for proper performance. It is not enough to wash the surface with a wet wipe. Proper rinsing requires flowing water. Now, before moving on to the Part B treatment, you must check to confirm that the surface is water break free. A water break free surface will have an unbroken film of water that should remain on the surface without beating up for 30 seconds. If the stencil looks like this, then you're ready to proceed to the next step. If the stencil does not support an unbroken sheet of water, as seen here, then the stencil is not water break free and reapplication of the primer is required until a water break free surface is achieved. If you have achieved a water break free surface, then you are ready to proceed to treatment with the Part B. The Part B treatment needs to be applied to a dry surface. Prior to application, be sure that the stencil is completely dry by drying with a clean room wipe or an air gun attached to an oil-free air or nitrogen source. Remember, be sure you are ready to apply the Part B immediately upon opening the wipe. The treatment will evaporate quickly and may not perform as desired if not immediately applied. Open the Part B treatment wipe and wipe the stencil for at least 60 seconds. Be sure to apply heavy pressure while applying the Part B, as though you were buffing wax on a car. Remember, proper application of the treatment is critical for final desired performance. Wipe any excess liquid from the surface with a dry, clean room wipe. It is not necessary to buff or use pressure when drying the surface. You can test treated stencil's performance by evaluating if water droplets bead tightly on the surface and shed from the stencil easily when tilted. The Aculon test pen should bead up when applied to a properly treated stencil, as seen here. If you are not seeing water bead, or if your Aculon test pen does not bead up, then please see the troubleshooting guide included in your NanoClear 10 pack for more information.
Congratulations, you've now applied the Aculon NanoClear treatment. Thank you for watching this video, and if you have any additional questions, please visit our website at www.aculon.com. Thank you.